Hi there.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Going to
You message something?
be Manav, this message that is
Okay.
going to be me 15 minutes later.
Sean has link already. Please start, I will catch up. We'll run fast. Yesterday, I took the basic for Sean. He talked to you?
No, I'm not speaking.
You all three are friend, no? So yeah we were dealing with the boundary conditions and critical points, maximum minimum. Right.
A little bit of background noise was started from your side.
It's probably from fan. No, it's slow. I slow down my fan.
So we'll start practicing like boundary questions, right? Where,
Yeah,
okay,
yeah, yeah. We just did one question on that. The boundary was rectangle, right? Today we'll that was easy. Like we know what is constant. So like x is equal to 2, x is equal to minus 2, y is equal to 1, y is equal to minus 1. But the boundary could be anything, any curve. It may be rectangle, triangle, it may be circle, anything, right? So based on that, how would we find out critical points, end points? So we'll be going to practice two questions, most probably two questions on that, and then we'll enter into the climax of this chapter, as I already promised, it is going to be more interesting. So that is Lagrange multiplier. Lagrange multiplier. Integral is the other chapter, other show. These guys are now, I think they are understanding everything, like they are more confident now than me also, I think. Hi Sean, good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah.
Nothing. Just woke up.
Okay. We are waiting for Mano. We will not wait. Rather, I was waiting for you only. Now we will start.
Sorry.
So let me share my page with you. See, this is like for you, Sean. This is going to be, you are joining the climax of the movie, kind of. So you won't, entertained by the climax. So I'll try to explain you the summary of the movie, right? Today. So today is going to be, end of the first chapter, right? And this is very much interesting. This chapter is going to be, this class is going to be very much interesting. I have already promised to Dev and Manav. So I know your constraint here. Like, you are not going to understand the climax today, but I'll try my best to make you understand also. Okay.
Got it.
So, you can see the, you know, the page on your screen, right? Okay. So, we were doing like the boundary condition test. Yeah, Dave, we were doing the boundary condition test. So we are going to explore that topic with two questions today. Okay. That is, I'm putting up the question right now. So the first, the second question basically is, if f of x comma y is equal to 3x square plus 2xy plus y square, and the region is defined as the triangle bound by minus 2 comma minus 1, okay, 1 comma minus 1, and 1 comma 2, okay. Actually, the I want to give little bit information to Sean about this. The Mano was very much, you know, used to explain this thing actually. So, because he has already drawn XYZ plane on his desk, so, and he kept one, you know, box, isn't it, Dev? That was very, you know, simple to understand. Okay, let Mano join, then we'll discuss that. Before that, I would like to explain you already. See, what yesterday also we saw f of x comma y is equal to, you start thinking on this, Dev. I'm giving little bit, you know, the basic information to Sean about this. Okay, you can start. You start drawing the boundary condition. You start thinking on that, then we'll come to that. Okay. So, Sean, we have already seen that f of x comma y is a surface, right? It is not a curve. It is a surface of any object. It is a surface, isn't it? Right? So, as you can see, f of x comma y is equal to 3x square plus 2xy plus y square is mentioned. So, it will give you a surface rather than a curve, because it is a three-dimensional object, right? So, the boundary is basically like this boundary is on xy plane, first of all, understand. This boundary is on xy plane. So if I draw x and y plane like this, this is x, this is y, this is z. Okay, so this boundary is triangle. This boundary is triangle. So what the boundary means here? Okay, so we are going to plot these points on xy plane. Okay, this is xy. Now minus 2 comma minus 1. So before, let me plot these points, then I'll explain you. This is minus 2, minus 1, minus 1, minus 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. So minus 2 comma minus 1 is somewhere here, okay? And 1 comma minus 1, 1 comma minus 1 is here, 1 comma 2, so 1 comma 2 is here. Right, so this is nothing but a triangle that you can observe here. But where is this triangle lies, and what it is going to be, you know, do with this surface? Okay, so that's the question basically, right? You must be wondering about this type of relation. So basically, see, if you understand any surface, right, any surface, so surface is above z axis, right? The surface could be anywhere here. If I try to plot the surface could be anywhere here, right? Isn't it? This is a surface. So if some constraint, some limitation, if I'm providing here, like I want to just focus on a part, you know, which is a project, the part of the curve, part of the surface, which gives the projection as a triangle. Are you getting? That gives a projection as a triangle. So we are going, see, if I refer these points here like this on the surface, so this is something like this, you know, Are you getting this? Not probability triangle, maybe some sort of shape which is like triangle itself.
Wait, so you need to find the area of that?
Not the area exactly. See, did you understand what I have projected here? The triangle is basically the boundary condition I'm giving here, because the surface is going to be expand infinitely. So we are not going to discuss anything with infinite expansion of the surface, right? We have to limit something. So if suppose we are talking about volume also, so we have to provide some boundary, then only we can find out the volume under the curve, right? So in that sense, if we have a boundary condition here as a triangle, okay, so the projection of that is basically on the surface that you can visualize here, right? So the purpose of putting a boundary and showing it on the surface is to find out the critical point. We are actually dealing with the extrema of the multivariable function. Okay. Okay. We are basically dealing with the extrema of multivariable function. So what is extrema for the regular function? Maxima, minima, right? Like we have done in IB, the maxima and minima is relative mean, relative max is the extrema of multivariable function. So similarly, we are dealing with the maxima and minima of the multivariable function. So multivariable function is basically a surface. So we are dealing with the maxima and minima of the surface. Are you getting? If the surface is like this, if the surface is like this, this is relative minima, right? If the surface is like this, then that is relative maxima. Do you understand? So in the shortest way, I can explain you like this. So if I provide the boundary condition, like I have provided triangle over here in this question, if I provide you the boundary condition, so the core idea is basically the maxima and minima of the surface, of the defined surface, right? As per the boundary of that defined surface will lie within that boundary, either on the boundary of the condition, right, or within the boundary. Like the points are there inside this, lot of points will be there inside it, right? So within the boundary.
Okay.
Right.
Wait, so at the end of the question, what are we supposed to get as an answer?
We have to find the points, okay, that gives the either maxima or minima. Yeah, critical points, right? Okay. See, the maxima or minima happens on the critical points, right? So we are going to find the critical points where the surface will have either maxima, relative maxima, or relative minima. That we are going to find out here. Okay, like if this is, suppose this is a curve, okay, where is relative maxima, relative minima? This is relative maxima, this is relative minima, again this is relative maxima, right? So this is, we are going to find out for the surface, not for the curve, right? So what about you, Dev?
So I found, I started finding the points which are generally critical points, and I found one which lies inside. I found only one, and that's origin.
Okay.
0,0. And then what I started doing is I don't know if you have to do this, but I made an equation for the hypotenuse. I made an equation of the line of the hypotenuse. That's correct.
Yeah, perfect. So, see, we are looking for now.
Yeah.
Please, can anybody call Manav?
Yeah, I'll call him. He's on another call.
What's going on? Okay, so Manav will work this by one. So see, there are how many boundary here?
Three boundaries.
Yeah.
There are three boundaries, right? One, two, and three. Okay. So let's work on the simplest here, the simplest boundary here, which is boundary number one and boundary number two, because something is constant over there. What is constant? Y is equal to one minus one is constant, and like for first boundary, y is equal to minus one, right? Is it visible properly, the screen?
It's a bit blur. Yeah, it's a blur.
Blur, no? Okay, I think it will retain after some time. Okay, so y is equal to minus 1 is the condition of the boundary, right? So what we are supposed to substitute here? Y is equal to minus 1 and x is equal to x here in the function, right?
Yeah.
Here. So we will get a function in one variable, right? So when we do that, we'll get a function in one variable, which is x minus 1, that is equal to 3x square plus 2x, y is minus 1 plus minus 1 square, right? So this is going to be 3x square minus 2x plus 1. Did you understand this? So we'll get some curve on the surface, right? We'll get some curve. Okay, we are not worrying about what type of curve we are getting. We just get a curve. In the curve is basically in terms of one independent variable, right? On the surface of the boundary condition. So when we differentiate this, so we will get 3 to the 6 minus 2, right? So I request Dev and Manav to explain something, you know, about this after the class, also to Sean, so that Sean will be comfortable after class, right? Yeah, okay. So please do that from my behalf, so he should not miss anything. So this is the derivative, right? So how do we find out critical point? We simply set this equal to 0, right? This is what we do to find out the critical point.
Yeah.
Isn't it? So when we do that, so we will get x is equal to 2 by 6, which is 1 by 3, right? So this is the x coordinate. What is y coordinate?
Z.
See, the critical point will be, you know, the y in terms of ordered pair.
Minus one.
So the critical point is 1/3 minus one, right? What are the end point here? We also include end point. So what are the end point of this boundary condition?
The end point are minus 2 comma minus 1 and minus 1 comma minus 2.
1 comma minus 1. Right. So can you find out the values of the surface or the values of z values by plugging these points in the function? Please do that.
Yeah. Yeah, I got them. So 2/3 for this one. 2/3 for the first one, and for 1 minus 1 is 2.
Minus one.
For my 1 minus 1 is 2.
Okay. 1 minus.
I didn't do that one yet.
Okay. No, I didn't get that.
So for the last one, I got them. For the last one, I got 2.
Okay, fine. Hi, Mano. Good morning.
Hi, sir.
Where did you stuck?
The haircut.
No, I forgot about today's class.
Oh, awesome.
Huh? But why didn't you join? Like, one quick moment.
No, I had an AP exam yesterday, so I was awake till 2:30, and I forgot about this class.
So you would have missed the climax. Okay, I already promised Sean that you will show the yesterday arrangement of how this boundary will cut the surface and you will get a curve on that plane basically. Can you show that again?
Yeah.
Is it possible? Like, is it there?
Yeah.
So you at least work something like at least do some algebra. If you don't like you don't understand the 100% concept here, but at least you can do the algebra.
What's the end point in this thing?
That will be cleared from the model is going to show that.
So this is x. This horizontal axis is the x axis.
Yeah.
This is the y axis.
So that's an object, right? The surface which has. Okay.
Yeah.
So now take any scale or anything. So that is the boundary condition. Now that is z axis. You can understand that as a z axis. Okay. You understand that, Sean? We have x y plane and z axis, and there is an object, okay, that the surface we are talking about means f of x comma y will definitely give you such kind of object. Now this the Mano has holding is basically a the boundary condition, right? It is supposed to be just a line,
so it'll cut like that.
Yeah, so it will cut the object. So on that boundary of this plane, okay, that's the plane. Are you getting that? That's the plane, isn't it? So when you cut the object by plane, so you will definitely get a curve on the plane. You understand? You will get a curve on the plane, right? We are talking about the surface of the object. That's not whole. That's not cover the volume part. You just understand the surface. Do you understand?
Yeah.
So that if you cut the object by a plane, you can see on the screen. What happened to the screen today? Let me join this again. Just a second. Okay, so see, when this plane cuts the object, right? So object has surface like this. Object has surface like this. The liquid in that case. So that is the surface. So when this plane cut the object, you will get some curve on the plane. You understand now? You will get some curve on the plane. So similarly, each boundary will cut the object, okay, and it will have some curve. So we are talking about the maxima and minima of the surface. So that minima and maxima appears at the critical points. So now we are working on the critical points because each boundary will has some condition. So that condition is basically y is equal to minus 1 and we put x is varying here. So y is equal to minus 1 and we put x as x because x is varying. Is that it? X is changing. So we are putting this in the function, the given function, and we get an equation of a curve. That curve we are talking about here. Okay. We get the equation of a curve like this. Okay. We are not worrying about what type of curve we are getting, but we definitely get an equation. We get a curve. So now we can definitely find out critical points of that curve. You understand that? So when we do that, we have to differentiate that. And when we differentiate, we set that term equal to 0. That will give you the critical points, right? And at the same time, we check the boundary condition also. Is it a little bit clear to you?
Yeah. Okay. The critical points, the maximum, minimum, right?
Yeah. So this, we are going to check that. So is calculating his values that will help us to find out which one is maxima or which one is minima. Okay, so what did you find here for this endpoint, Dev? Minus 2 and minus 1?
17.
Very good. Okay, now what is the second boundary condition? The second boundary condition is for x is equal to 1. Is that right? So x is equal to 1. So what we'll do, we are working on the second boundary condition. So x is equal to 1. And what we are going to plug for y?
Y is equal to y.
Y equal to y.
Y because, is equal to y.
Yeah, y is changing. So y is variable. Right? X is constant. So we'll plug this.
You get in that. You get the end point when you do it. Like the vertices of the triangle is different.
Yeah, but we'll work everything. We'll see that. So, what is the function now? F of 1 comma y, right? So, 1 comma y will change the function like this. So, 3 plus 2y plus y square. Did you get this? I simply plug x is equal to 1 in the function. In the given function, right? So when you do that, you will get this curve. So critical point of this curve. So the derivative of this is 2 plus 2y. We'll set this equal to 0. This will give you the critical points. So minus 1, right? So what is the critical points here now?
Yeah.
What is the critical point? What is the x value?
1, minus 1.
What are the end points? We should not skip anything. otherwise they get it wrong. Okay, what are the end point? So end points are 1, -1. It may be repeated, I know that, but you should write everything.
Yeah.
1, 2. So now calculate the values of the function at these critical points. Okay.
So 1, -1 is 2.
Hmm.
1, 2 is 11.
11. Okay. And 1, -1 is same as 2. Yeah, both are same. Okay. So now what about this slant line? What about that, Mano?
So sir, I'm solving that.
Yeah. What will you do for that, for third boundary, Mano? Can you answer that?
So no.
Third boundary. What are you talking about? This one.
Yeah. The boundary is triangle. Okay. Yesterday, in last class we talked about triangle. Now it is triangle, right? So these two boundary condition, one and second, was same as the, you know, the thing we have already discussed, but this is the slant line here.
Yeah.
What about that? How do you, you know,
okay,
sort it out?
Slant line, would have a gradient, right?
Perfect, very good. So it will have a constant gradient, right? Right? So what is the gradient?
Yeah,
what is the gradient in that case?
0.927.
Okay. Will not do, will not put it in decimal. 1, 2 and this is
2, -1.
Right. So let me do the Excel. 2 + 1/(1+2). What is the gradient now? 1.
Oh, so when I used the calculator and I did the angles and all, I don't know why I got like a decimal.
What did you get?
So I took the base as 3, the height as 4, and the hypotenuse as 5, and then I did a sine inverse.
Okay.
Of 4/5.
You must have done some mistake.
No,
you must have done
tan of that angle, right?
Yeah. Tan of that.
Yeah.
Opposite upon adjacent. Why are we doing that? If we have we got 2 points here, why are we wasting time on doing trigonometry on this? Okay. So the slope is 1. Right, the slope is 1. What is the equation of this line? Sean, we answer this. What would be the equation of this line?
Y equals to x plus 1.
Y is equal to
x plus 1.
Okay, let's do that. So, y minus 1 is equal to 1, x minus 2. Right, so y is equal to x minus 2 plus 1. So, y is equal to x minus 1. What did you say? Y is equal to x. I got y is equal to x.
Sir, but how can it be?
The equation.
Except is 1, right?
Yeah. See, what's the equation of a line? Y minus y naught is equal to slope x minus x naught. This is the equation of a line having slope m, and these are the points on the line.
Switched.
So you switch it. Y minus 2 and x.
My bad. So y minus 2, x minus 1. Right. So y minus 2, 2 will come here, 1. Yeah. So Sean was right. So the equation of this line is y is equal to x plus 1. Okay. What a great mistake. Okay. So y is equal to x plus 1 is the line. So we can plug now for the reason for the boundary 3, x is equal to x and y is supposed to be x plus 1, isn't it? So we'll plug this in the function, right? So the function will be x comma x plus 1 is equal to what it's supposed to be, 3x square plus 2x x plus 1 plus x plus 1 the whole square, right? Plus. So when we simplify this, what we get, 3x square plus 2x square plus x square 2x plus 1.
Yeah.
Okay. When we simplify this further, we will get this.
Yeah.
Isn't it? So f of x, comma x plus 1. Right? Now what next step?
Yeah.
This is the curve on the surface.
If derivative equal to 0,
so we'll find out derivative of this, which is 12x plus 4. We set this equal to 0. So x equal to how much?
-1/3.
Right?
-1/3.
And what is y? What is y?
2/3.
So 1 minus 1 by 3 plus 1. Right, so 3 minus 1, 2 by 3. So the critical point is minus 1 by 3, 2 by 3, and what are the end point? What are the end
point? Take it into account.
Right? Yeah, we have already considered that, but we should practice that way. Minus 2, minus 1, 1, 2. Minus 2, minus 1, 1, comma 2. We already calculated that. Right. So what is the value of this critical point for the function? Did you calculate that?
Yeah, I'm finding. I'm doing that.
Okay. Let's check if you get this.
Yeah. 1/3. Yeah.
So now, can you tell, Sean, can you tell what is minima, and have we considered all the points so far? Have we considered all the points?
No.
Which points are left?
You have to do the like overall of the thing, like without taking the boundary into
consideration. Yeah, we have to look for the critical points of the surface. If that point lies within the boundary,
original,
that's significance for us.
Right. Origin.
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 Or any points.
And
suppose
the, and the intercepts. And the intercepts.
If the there is a surface, right?
Yeah.
We'll find out the critical points of the surface by finding out partial derivative. Isn't it? We'll set partial derivative to 0. We'll find the critical points of the surface. And if that point lies within the boundary, that is significant for us. If that point lies outside the boundary, why we are worrying about that? We will not take into account. Are you getting that? Because we are just dealing with the boundary.
Mm.
That boundary is restricting that, like it's working as a domain. Isn't it? So if some point is outside domain, we don't deal with that. Right? So we'll find out partial derivative of the function. Then we can conclude which one is maxima and which one is minima. So let me know the partial derivative here. That is with respect to x and with respect to y of the function.
6x plus 2y, and the other one is 2x plus 2y.
Is equal to 0. We'll set that equal to 0 to find out the critical points. And 2x plus 2y is equal to 0. Right? So, how do we find out critical point in this case?
Simultaneous equation.
Yes. So, we'll solve this simultaneously. So what we get, we will get 4x, we subtract, right? So 4x is equal to 0, x is equal to 0, and
y
is equal to 0, right? So critical point is 0 comma 0. Is it within the boundary? Is it within the boundary?
It is within.
Yes. So that point is significant for us, right? So what is the value of the function at that point?
Zero.
Now let me know the relative maxima and relative.
Relative 17 at -2, -1, and relative minima is 0 at 0, 0.
So, one last question on this. Is it absolute maxima or absolute minima in this case?
Yeah, I guess it is, right? But for the when you're taking the region into consideration, it is, I
think. Definitely, definitely. It is absolute maxima and absolute minima. Because we have restricted the surface. Okay? And now we are finding the maximum minimum value of the surface. Did you understand that? So that is absolute maxima and minima. Right? So now do you remember, like, in optimization condition, like in optimization problem in calculus 1, what we are supposed to do? We find out the maxima, you know, and minima of the given function. Like for the profit, it may be for the profit, it may be for the cost of production. We minimize cost of production, we maximize profit. Do you understand that? So we are going to enter into that world by doing this. Are you getting where I am approaching my concept? So we are approaching towards that area, the optimization problem. Are you getting that? So these are the boundary condition. We have a function of that is a surface, and we find out the critical points that is giving us the absolute minima or absolute maxima. You understand that? So let's now I put the next question. And I think the working, as far as the algebra is concerned, I think Sean has understood the working of this.
Yeah.
Right? So now you start working on this question. The function is f of x, comma y is equal to x minus x square. On region bound by y is equal to x square and y is equal to 4. For most thing, what will you do? What will you do?
Draw a diagram.
We'll draw the region. We'll draw the region.
Yeah.
Done.
So, yeah. Let me draw. So you must have got parabola. What about you, Sean? Have you drawn the region?
Yeah. With the
yeah. Yeah. So, yeah. We'll draw the region on XY plane, because this region is shoot up on the surface, and it will give you some, you know, the critical points and boundary condition, everything on the surface, right? So we are going to draw this region. Y is equal to x square is here, like this. This is the parabola. Y is equal to x square, and we have y is equal to 4. So y is equal to 4 is like this, right? So how many boundaries are there?
There are like three
boundary points.
Or actually, you can say two boundaries.
Yeah, it has two boundaries, one and two.
Okay. Yeah.
So let's work on boundary first. If you keep writing about the partial derivative part, that is the critical point of the surface, you do that first, right? you may forget, like after doing a lot of critical points and end points, you may forget about that at the end. So you do that first. You find out the partial derivative of the given function with respect to x and partial derivative of the given function with respect to y. Okay? So partial derivative of with respect to x here, we keep y constant. For you, Sean, we keep y constant. Yeah. We differentiate that with respect to x. Okay?
Yeah.
So the derivative will be y minus 2x.
Minus 2x.
Right? Set this equal to 0.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, what about with respect to y? So that's x. Just x.
X is equal to 0.
So when we set this equal to 0 and we put this back in the above equation, what we get? Y is equal to 0. So the critical point is 0, 0. Is it significant?
It's one of our endpoints.
Yes. It is on the boundary. So obviously we are going to consider that also. So 0, 0, what would be the significance for it? Because we are referring all these values for the surface. Okay. So surface will be basically
0.
So 0. So when you plug 0, 0 in the function, you will get 0. So that is, now we'll look at the end whether it is maximum or minimum. Okay. Now work on the boundary 1 and 2. For boundary 1, what you are going to do, we will put y is equal to 4 and x is equal to how much?
2.
X is equal to 2.
No. And minus 2, that's what I said.
No, no, no.
The endpoints, like you.
You are saying
you can take the.
So what?
X is equal to
x. X is equal to x, and then you can. If it's bound or not, like after solid.
Okay.
You should get a curve, na? Curve on the plane for this condition. So y is equal to 4, x is equal to x will give you the function x comma 4, that is x comma 4. So 4x minus x square. Yeah. We'll differentiate minus this, which is 4 minus 2x. Set this equal to 0.
Minus
x is equal to 2. What is y equal to 2? Y is equal to 4. What is 2 comma 4. What is the value of the function at this point?
It is 4.
What are the endpoints?
2 comma 4 which we got and minus 2 comma 4.
Yeah.
Minus 2 comma 4. Did you understand this, Sean? We simply solve them simultaneously. We will get the value of x, right? So x is basically 2 and here it is minus 2, right? So the endpoints are minus 2.4 and 2.4. So what are the values at these endpoints?
So that's 4 again and minus 12.
4 and minus 12. Now let's talk about the region 2. What we are going to plug for x and y in region 2, in boundary 2.
Boundary 2, you substitute y as x square, right?
Y as x square and x is equal to x, right? So f of x comma x square is equal to x into x square minus x square, which is x cube minus x square. Set this equal to 0. What are we getting here? No, not this. First we differentiate this, right?
No, you have to find the derivative and then equate that.
Yeah, So we'll differentiate this first. 3x square minus 2x. Then we set this equal to 0. So what are we getting? X is equal to 0.
And 2 by 3.
Yeah. Or x is equal to 2 by 3. What happened to Sean? Hello. Can you hear us, Sean?
So I solved it.
Yeah. Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So what's the critical point here? 0, 2 by 3. What did you get?
0, huh? So 0.
Sorry. I thought that's done here. So for x is equal to 0, what is y? 0. For x is equal to 2 by 3, what is
square
y?
Of that.
4 by 9, right?
0.
So this is one of the critical point. This is 0, 0. And this is another critical point, which is 0, 2 by 3, 4 by 9. Let me know the values at these critical points.
Minus 4 by
27. 0 and 4 by 27. Okay. So where is absolute max and absolute mean here? Did you observe it here?
Absolute max is...
What is the value of absolute max? What is the maximum value of the sub function?
The absolute max is 4, but it's at like at where both the places intersect is the maximum. The minimum, like
these are
the other one is minus 12, which is where the line is.
See, this is absolute max and this is absolute mean. Okay, so this happened at the same point. If you observe, that happened at the same point. So you can write absolute max is 4 at 2, 4. Okay, and absolute mean is minus 12 at minus 2, 4. You don't understand this?
Yeah.
Okay. Now let me put one first question on optimization. The real problem basically. That's write down the question. The question is minimize the material needed to create an open box with a volume of 108.
Is Nick?
Sorry.
Your pen is running out of.
it's not like that. It's not like that.
Right.
It will appear slowly. I think it's a magic pen right now. Okay. Now say you, I want your focus for half an hour, the complete focus, because now we are going to enter into Lagrange multiplier. Okay, that is a new concept we are going to learn today. And the whole concept, see, we have been working on derivative of multivariable function, I think, since 10th class. So this is going to be the end of this, and we are going to use all the aspect of that derivative concept here today. Okay, and why we have learned so much that you will understand today. Okay, so this is the first question on optimization. What should be your approach on this? We have to minimize the material, right? We have to minimize the material needed to create an open box with a volume of 108 inch cube. Okay, what is an open box? So if I draw, if I simply enter Manav also, okay, if I simply draw the open box here, let's say this is the open box. Okay, is it open box? It's not visible properly. So now this is an open box, right?
There can be multiple configurations for this, right?
Yeah. So that configuration we are going to find out now. We are going to find out that dimension only, which minimize the material. Okay. So how would we say that the material is minimized? What, where the material is going to be used in this? For volume or for surface?
Yeah.
It's a hollow box, right?
Hollow box. Box? Box? Hollow? I don't understand. The box is supposed to be hollow only.
Yeah. Box.
So
so
surface, right? So we are, the material is going to be used in the surface. So what is the surface area? We are interested in minimizing the surface area, basically, because then in that case the material is going to be minimized, right? So what is the surface area here?
Yeah,
if I give you the dimensions x, y, and z, okay, x, y, and z, what is the surface area?
xy plus 2xz.
Okay, 2x. So that's the surface area, right? And they have given one constraint here, that is volume of this cube or volume of this box is
equal to
xyz is equal to
108.
Right, so what should be our first approach for solving this? We can use this constraint xyz is equal to 108, okay, to eliminate one of the variable of the surface of the formula. Right, we'll use that. So we'll eliminate z, and z is basically 108 upon xy, right?
Yeah.
So when we substitute z is equal to 108 upon xy here, so xy plus 2y into 108 upon xy plus 2x 108 upon xy. Okay, so s is equal to xy plus 216 upon x square plus 216 upon y, not x square, just x and y, right? Because y will cancel out, x will cancel out. Right? So we got a function in two variable. You understand this? We got a function in two variable.
Yeah.
And the question reduced here. We have to minimize this function. We have to minimize this function. Right? So for that, what we are going to find out? We are going to find out variables. Is that okay? And by using second order derivative test, we'll find whether the that critical point is maxima or minima. Head yes, if you understood this.
Yeah.
Okay. So how do we find out critical points?
Partial
derivative. Perfect. So half of you will find out x and half of you will find out sy.
So I found both already.
Okay. So I said half for Mano, half for Sean. I knew that. So for partial, we'll talk about partial derivatives in the one-on-one class. Why? What is partial derivative and how it look like? But you just for time being, you consider one of the variable as constant. Like if you are finding partial derivative with respect to x, hold y constant, and for with respect to y, hold x constant. Okay. Yeah. So verify if you get this y minus 216 upon x square.
Yeah.
And x minus 216 upon
x minus 216 upon y square. Yeah.
So what's the next step? We set that equal to
0.
So how do we find out critical points? This is y is equal to 216 upon x square. Yes, simultaneously solving. So we'll plug this, we'll use this condition here in this equation. So x minus 216 upon x square is equal to 0, right? So
yeah,
this is going to be x minus x raised to 4 upon 216. 1216 will cancel out. You can take x common, you can take x common. So 1 minus x cube upon 216 is equal to 0. So what are the critical points here?
Yeah.
What are the different values of x?
X is equal to 0, but then y is undefined. So you can eliminate that.
Perfect. See, if you put x is equal to 0, means there is no volume. There is no volume at all. Like you are working on plane. If you set x is equal to 0, look at the diagram. If there is x is equal to 0, right? There is no width of the box. So you don't have box basically. Right? So x is equal to 0 is invalid. So x 1 minus 1 minus x cube upon 216 is equal to 0. So x is equal to how much? 6.
Yeah.
Right? X cube is equal to 216 and the cube root of 216 is 6. So x is equal to 6.
Yeah.
What is y?
216 divided by 36, which is 6. Yeah, obviously. 6.
So 6, okay, let me write this full. 216 upon 36, which is 6. Okay, what is z?
Yeah.
What is z? If you have 6, 6, what is z?
That is
108 upon, 108 upon xy. So So 108 upon 6 into 6.
Yeah.
So what's that? 108 upon 6.
Which is 3.
Right?
Yeah.
So the required dimension is 6, 6, 3. But how do we say, how do we say whether it is minima or maxima?
The derivative test.
Second derivative test, right? So we got the point here, but we have to prove whether it is maxima or minima. We have to minimize the material required, right? So we have to minimize the function. We have to minimize S. So the second order derivative test is basically dx, y is equal to SXX SYY minus what? Not visible. Lot of interruption right today.
Most of the time when there is rain.
So, for second derivative test, SXX, SYY minus, minus what?
Minus XY squared, SXY squared.
Square, right. So, do that. Find out all these partial derivative first. And then find out this term.
But for, solving it, can't we just analyze the nature by seeing the signs and all, like overall, like because SXY is 1. And like you can easily see like.
Yeah. See, you can calculate this basically. SXX. What is that? Can you calculate this? SXX.
Yeah.
So
we
have X upon X cube.
X is,
216 upon x cube. 216 upon x cube, right? Plus 216 upon x cube. So if you have x is equal to 6, this is going to be, you know, for x is equal to 6, this is going to be positive, right? When this is positive, what happened? Well, first one is positive. See, the second derivative test is going to be positive. Yeah.
So shouldn't it be 216 into by x cube? Like you have to multiply by 2 again, right?
So basically we are focusing on the sign of this. So when you have 216, you know, into 2, obviously that is going to be how much? I think 432. Yeah. So 432 of x cube. So for x is equal to 6, 432 upon x cube is going to be positive. Right, so second derivative test means second order derivative along x direction is positive. Is positive means concave up. Concave up. Right, concave up means we have a critical point which is relative minima. Do you understand that? See, the second derivative is going to be positive. That obviously will get that as positive number. So the main focus is basically on S of XX. Right, either of the term S of XX or S of YY, both will be positive. Then only you are getting DXY as positive, isn't it? So obviously if it is positive, we have a concave up figure with us. So that critical point is basically relative minima. So that's minimize the material. So the dimension is basically 6, 6, 3 is the required dimension that will minimize the material required, keeping volume as 108. Head yes if you understood this. Okay. Now let's move to next important topic. I think I will be able to finish just theory of it today. The question will left no problem. So the topic is Lagrange multiplier. See, what was the problem here? Like, if you have like the, did you find any anything here which is you don't want to do? Like, if we have a, you know, if we have three dimensional function, three independent variable, four independent variable, are you getting that? Here it was three independent variable. How many independent variables was there? For surface area, it was three independent variable, x, y, and z. What we did? We want to reduce the function from three independent variable to two independent variable, isn't it?
Yeah.
If suppose we have four independent variable, what will you do? So that's the problem, basically. That's the problem.
Yeah.
If you have a three, you substitute that, you apply the constraint, you substitute, you convert it into three independent. So if you do this, by using this method, it's going to be a lot of, problematic. So what we are doing right now, we are entering into a method which reduces all of the, right? And that's multiplier. There we are not supposed to substitute the constraint, right? We are not going to use that constraint like how we did here. So that's interesting, isn't it? And that is Lagrange multiplier. Okay, lambda, you can write there itself. That is lambda. Okay, so now understand the concept here. We have done level curve before, right? Have we done level curve?
Yeah.
Have we done contour map?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So before that, if I want to, graph this function, this surface area, if I want to graph this function, especially this one, okay, since there are two variables involved. So the function, if I set this to any constant, so this will give you the level curve, any sort of level curve, for the different values of S. Are you getting that? It may not be circle. I'm not saying that you will always get a circle. Are you getting? But you will definitely get a level of different values of this, right? What we are doing here, this is also, this is also a level curve. You understand that? X, Y, Z is equal to 108. Can you write that function as X, Y, Z is equal to W? And if you set W is equal to 108, what will you get? See, the constraint is basically x, y, z is equal to 108. Are you getting that? The constraint is x, y, z is equal to 108. So the function is basically W is equal to z of x, y, z. Right? So dependent variable dependent on x, y, z. They are three independent variables. So if I equate the function is equal to 108, any constant value, what will you get? You will get the level curve.
Yeah.
Right. So this is the level curves of whole lot of level curves of S of X, Y, Z. Right. And this is also one level curve. Right. This is one level curve. Are you getting that? Because we are set that equal to 108, a particular constant. So one level curve will, like this. Can I draw? They will definitely intersect on XY plane. Are you getting that? So where we are interested in, the point where they actually touch and bounce back. have you ever thought of this? Like we worked on the algebra part of it, but have you ever thought of this? Like how do we use the constraint? Are you getting that? So if we try to graph the given function,
I didn't understand that.
Yeah, that second curve.
What is
it like? Yeah, this is basically your g of x, y, z is equal to constant. It will give you one level curve. Okay, it will give you one level curve. What we are finding out here, that level curve will touch the surface somewhere. Okay, now think about this. These level curves are the different level curves at different height. Are you getting that? Right. So
right.
I have drawn that on XY plane like a contour map. I have drawn that on XY plane, right? Like a contour map. So it is possible, isn't it? Like if you have a function S, right? If you have a function S, S of X comma Y comma Z, we can have a contour map. We can have a level curve. We can have a contour map. So how this constraint basically come into the picture? And what is the relation? See, we found this solution x is equal to 6, y is equal to 6, z is equal to 3. That is basically the common solution of, are you getting that? We got a solution x is equal to 6, y is equal to 6, z is equal to 3. That is a common solution of the constraint as well as the surface. Are you getting that?
Yeah.
It means they are going to intersect somewhere. The curve are going to intersect somewhere, isn't it? So if I have drawn lot of level curves of the surface, are you getting the level curves can be obtained by slicing the object by horizontal plane, isn't it? So we'll get lot of level curves, isn't it? So if the surface is like this, a surface can be like this, you know, the surface can be like this or it can be like this, right? So if the level curve, the constraint, I'm talking about this constraint, which is itself a level curve. Are you getting? So that level curve will definitely touch the surface. That will definitely touch the surface. So I'm not interested in the whole surface basically.
Yeah.
It will touch a level curve of the surface. Are you getting that?
Yeah.
Right? Let me try once again.
Yeah,
I was ready for that actually. I wanted to show you once again. See, this is the object, right? This is the surface. You understand that? This is the mountain range. You can imagine that this is a mountain range, this is a peak, right? We are finding out the we are going to apply the constraint. See, this is the constraint. It will give you level curve. Are you getting that? This is a constraint. It will give you a level curve because we have already set x, y, g of x, y, z is equal to 108. That will give you a level curve. So this level curve, we are finding the common solution. We are finding the common solution of this as well as the constraint. So this level curve will definitely touch it. Where it touches. It will not touch the whole surface of this object. It will touch at some level curve basically. That is at certain height.
Yeah.
Are you getting
that? In this case, 108. In this case, it would
sir,
have
I got that. But
no. In this, just a second, Mano. It is not 108. That is a level curve for the constraint. Are you getting? That is the level curve for the constraint.
Now, Mano, you can ask your doubt.
So we are saying that the green part or the silver curve of the bottle is the level curve of the
surface
of an external surface, right?
Yes.
But what is this? Like, what kind of when do we consider this?
See, now let's come to the in terms. So I was taking that because you understood that S of X, Y, Z is basically a surface, right? Because we were dealing with the actual problem.
Yeah.
S of x, y, x, x, y, z is basically a surface of three independent variables. Are you getting that? So what we are going to find out, we are going to find out the minimum value of S, isn't it? We are going to find out the minimum value of S. So you simply plug 0, 0, 0. That would be the minimum. Can we do that? Can we do that? No, we can't do that. No.
We can't do that because it has a volume.
Yeah, it has a volume. We can't do that. Even we can't simply plug any other values like 1, 2, 3. We cannot do that even.
Yeah.
What we are doing, basically, we are looking for a constraint. That volume must be 108. Right? That volume must be 108.
Yeah.
So, if I explore that constraint little bit, x, y, z is equal to 108. So, if I explore that, what is that? That is basically a level curve of a function w is equal to z of x, y, z.
Yeah.
Did you understand that? If I go to constraint, you get a level curve of that constraint, of that constraint function. You will get a level curve of that constraint function. You simply have one curve. Are you getting that? You simply have one curve. Now we are looking for an intersection point or the point where that curve touches the surface. Are you getting that? That's the whole idea behind it. If you understood this, this is the whole idea about Lagrange. I have not included lambda yet, right? I'm just giving you the concept behind it. I'll introduce lambda and all working later, but you first understand the concept. Do you understand the concept about the level curve of the constraint function and the function itself, the main function, the surface which we are talking about?
Yeah.
Did you understand that?
Yeah.
So if you have a function like the surface, okay, let me try again. Concept. If you have a function like f of x, y is equal to c, what is going to be give you?
What's going to be?
This is surface.
Hello.
Yeah. What this going to give you? This will give you surface.
Oh.
This will give you a surface. So if I set this z is equal to constant, like f of x comma y is equal to some constant c1 or c2 or c3, what it will give us now?
Wait, so don't you mean the first one is object and this?
Yeah, object, definitely object. But we talk about the surface. See, this is the object.
And then
this is the
level curve.
Yeah, so this will give us the level curve, right? When we set z is equal to constant, this will give you the level curve, right? So if I draw those level curves here.
Yeah.
So these are the level curves. You understand? These are the level curves. Now have the example of mountain range in your mind. You can imagine that always, right? Imagine that. So these are the level curves of f of x, y. F of x comma y is equal to c1, c2, c3, etc. There are a lot of level curves, right? Now, what is constraint here? See, the constraint is g of x, y is equal to c. Right? G of x, y is equal to c. So if you just consider this and put it like this, z is equal to g of x comma y. This itself a function. It's itself a multivariable function. But we are not dealing with the whole function altogether. We are simply dealing with the constraint, and that is basically a level curve of this function. Because we already said this z is equal to c, so this itself a level curve. Do you understand that? One level curve. Right? So the constraint is one level curve. Do you understand that? Because I have already said that, you know, g is equal to some constant. So that gives us one level curve. Are you getting that?
Hmm.
So can we plot that level curve on xy plane? Can we plot that level curve on xy plane? Definitely. We can plot that. So if I plot that level curve on xy plane, right? So let's, this is the level curve on xy plane. It will bounce with the surface at some point. Okay? That level curve will bounce from the surface of the object at some point. Right? So basically we are finding out, so this becomes the critical points. This becomes the critical points that we are looking for. Right? So either maxima or minima will happen at that critical point. Are you getting that?
Right.
See, we are looking for the common solution. What is constraint? Constraint is some condition for the given function. So we are looking for the common solution of the function and the constraint. Are you getting that? So I'm trying to picturize everything here. I'm going to picturize everything. So the constraint is basically a level curve itself. We have a surface. So that constraint will touch the surface at some point. And we are looking for that point where it touches. Are you getting that? We are looking for that point where it touches, and that becomes the critical point. Okay?
Yeah.
Okay. So you can write here the intersection gives constraint maxima or minima. Okay, this is for this. The intersection gives constraint maxima or minima.
So can you scroll a bit up? Can you scroll a bit up?
Yeah. Now just complete this. Then I will do the general.
Sir, after the class, can you send the pictures on the group of today's notes?
Yeah, I'll send that.
Whatever is always
copying this down, man.
Can I take like half an hour more today? Because I want all of this, the working of this as well as.
So I have my other class, man, which actually started at 12:30.
12:30, okay. So actually, I will stop Lagrange multiplier concept. I should use that also. Otherwise, it no sense here, right? If I give you the formula, I should use that.
Yeah.
Then only it makes sense. You can relate that. Okay. So I'm not giving you the formula right now. At least I'm giving you the concept of what is optimization, what is constraint, and what is surface. Did you understand? understand all of this. Like this is the surface, this is the constraint. Constraint is a curve itself, it's a level curve itself. So it will touch the surface, it will touch the surface at single point, right? So that point satisfies both constraint as well as surface. That point satisfies both constraint as well as surface. So we are looking for that point, that common point. Okay, it may be one, it may be multiple. Okay, it may be multiple. So if we are looking for that, and that becomes the critical point, and you know the remaining story. Critical point, either the maxima will be there or the minima will be there. Understood?
Yes.
Okay. So what about you, Sean? Did you understand like at least 10% of today's class?
Yeah, I got most of it.
Okay, fine. I will try to get everything while taking you one-on-one so that I can relate this and this everywhere. You know, I have to jump from one chapter to the, here and there, to and fro. So ready for that also, that poster, right? Okay. Yeah. So
thank you, sir.
Bye-bye. We'll stop here. We'll meet
up. Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.